Singapore is under attack. Well, in the cyber world, that is. According to the 2010 Semantic State of Enterprise Security Study, two-thirds of businesses here have encountered cyber attacks in the past year. A poll of local businesses in 2009 showed that only 56% installed anti-spyware software and less than 50% back out their critical data regularly. This was revealed at the National Security Dialogue at Orchard Hotel on Tuesday, which was attended by some 700 business representatives.
Cyber attacks are not just limited to businesses. It can be directed at our telecommunications networks, maritime navigational systems, banking databases, stock exchanges, to name a few, which will severely damage the overall economy. We cannot simply carry on with business as usual, but must ingrain in ourselves and in our organizations what I would call a security mindset, and to put in place plans to prepare for major incidents to ensure that businesses can continue with minimal disruption.
Professor S. Jayakumar said Singaporeans should not underestimate the power of the Internet. On April 4th, 20-year-old full-time national serviceman Muhammad Fadil Abdul Hamid was detained under the Internal Security Act after he made online contact with a suspected Al-Qaeda recruiter, indicating his interest to embark on armed jihad overseas. Just 3 weeks ago, DBS customers were left without banking services for 7 hours after a technical glitch. Such incidents highlight the impact that one negative action can have on the community. The Infocom Development Agency, or IDA, says measures are in place to ensure companies here are protected against cyber threats. One such measure is the Cybersecurity Awareness Alliance.
The alliance, in partnership with trade associations and Singapore Infocom Technology Federation, also reach out to SMEs through platforms such as seminars, conferences, networking sessions, and educational services. Through these platforms, the Alliance can engage SMEs on various Infocom security topics.
Another initiative is the new Qualified Information Security Professional Program. To be launched in September, this is Singapore's first training and accreditation program for Infocom security professionals. Other steps taken include introducing sector-specific security programs, Infocom scholarships, and cybersecurity exercises to test companies' readiness to respond to large-scale cyber attacks at the national level. For more on the minister's speech, watch the News Squared clip.